Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Mohan Yellapantula. I lead the solutions go-to-market for connected mobility solution area with AWS Automotive. Today, I'm here with Dr. Humza Akhtar.
Yeah, I'm the principal for manufacturing and automotive at MongoDB. And today, we're going to show you some exciting stuff that we are doing together.
Overview of our agenda here. I'm going to quickly talk through the AWS Automotive solution areas. And then we'll talk about how do we unlock the full lifecycle value of data, connected vehicle data. And then we'll talk about Gen AI use cases for connected mobility that we have worked with MongoDB. And then also go in a little bit detail about the MongoDB Atlas developer data platform. And then finally, how AWS and MongoDB have come together to showcase connected vehicle experiences, unlocking the full lifecycle of value of data. So a quick overview of the AWS automotive solution areas. As you can see, we have about 8 different solution areas, and these help address the customer pain points in different business areas. And the key aspect of it is I want to zoom in on connected mobility and how do you create new experiences and new value generating connected mobility services is a key aspect of here. And the MongoDB Atlas Vector Search tool and AWS Gen AI tools coming together to showcase these new experiences is what we're going to talk about. Let me zoom in a little bit more about the connected mobility solution area. What are the workloads here? What are the use cases here? As you can see, we have 5 use cases here: connected vehicle platforms, analytics insights, vehicle data collection, and also providing connected edge and infrastructure aspects of it. So in this case, this use case would fall into the analytics and insights part of it. So if you take the lifecycle value of data, I want to talk about 3 personas here who are going to be the end benefactors of the data that is coming in from the vehicles. First are the consumers. How can they get new connected experiences during the ownership of their vehicle, so that their vehicle experience is continuously fresh throughout the ownership experience? The second is the OEMs, who can take the data that is coming in from these vehicles and then refine the features inside the vehicle, use it for R&D aspects of it, vehicle development aspects of it. And 3 are the actual mobility services providers and partners who can take advantage of the data that is coming in from these vehicles and then keep generating new mobility services out of it. So as you can look at it, it's both of an internal monetization and an external monetization of the data. So this part of it, we will take all these 3 personas here and showcase some use cases. 1 across predictive maintenance, 2 across building intelligent in-car experiences, 3 around route planning and optimization. And Humza is going to go in detail about how these use cases come together with MongoDB and AWS partnership.
All right, so let's go about building some use cases now. Before I go into it, I just want to explain what we offer from MongoDB side. So on the left-hand side, you see the self-managed MongoDB database instance. A lot of people know us as that open source document model database, which is very flexible, very fast. It powers your real-time applications. But on the right-hand side is our fully managed MongoDB Atlas developer data platform, which gives you the same database experience as you will get with an on-premise version of MongoDB, but it gives you much, much more. So I'm not going to go through all the features we offer. You can take a photo of this, but for connected vehicles and autonomous mobility space, we're going to focus on 3 aspects here. We're going to focus on the database. We're going to focus on Atlas Search, which is a full-text search engine. And it also includes vector search as well, so powers your Gen AI applications for connected mobility. And we're going to focus on device sync and device SDK, which is a little database that goes right inside the car. It provides local storage for the telemetry data that the car is producing, and it syncs the data back into the cloud. It will provide you with the bidirectional synchronization capabilities right out of the box. So taking these 3 offerings that we have, let's build a connected vehicle. We have a vehicle. And what we're going to do is we're going to put a device SDK inside that vehicle. So this is it comes with various SDKs. There's a C++ SDK that's generally available. We have our clients actually using the C++ SDK in the car right now. So you put that in, and this will provide you with this local object-oriented storage inside the vehicle. And then what it will do is it will use the device sync that is part of MongoDB Atlas offering, and you can set up MongoDB Atlas on AWS Cloud. And using device sync, it will sync all the data from vehicle to MongoDB sitting on AWS Cloud. And this synchronization is bidirectional. It will handle all the conflicts for you. It will handle all the network interruptions for you. If I'm at a place where there's no internet connectivity, my car will keep storing data locally, and then it will synchronize the data to the cloud when the internet comes back. Now, I can do the same. I can put the device SDK in the mobile apps as well. We provide Swift, Kotlin, Flutter, Java SDKs, and then you can have the same route established from data coming in from the car and going into the cloud, and then notifications going back into the mobile app. So that is what our clients, our OEM customers are using to build these meaningful customer experiences. And then you can take advantage of our database triggers and push data to Amazon EventBridge. And from there, you can set up your SageMaker model inside SageMaker Studio. You can run all sorts of predictive analytics on the data collected from the vehicle, send back the results into MongoDB, send down the alerts using either device sync, or you can set up a GraphQL endpoint inside MongoDB Atlas and push it down to web applications or any other applications of your choice. I will put a lot of QR codes in my slides. You can scan this QR code. It will take you to a GitHub repo where you can actually set all of this up yourself. There's step-by-step instructions provided. All right. So this is how we set up a use case of, let's say, predictive maintenance for connected vehicles. So we provide everything out of the box. You just take the building blocks and set it up. So we have customers like Volvo, for example, Volvo Group Connected Solutions, that is using MongoDB Atlas on AWS to do fleet management. They're tracking 65 million daily events coming from all sorts of different trucks out in the road. And you can read more about this story by scanning this QR code, just going to that link. The power that MongoDB provides is that flexibility, is that high speed availability, high availability, scalability. And then on top of that, it is running on AWS, which provides that infrastructure that powers this massive application, and they can store a lot of telemetry data in their system. Moving on, we talked a little bit about connected vehicles. Now I'm going to bring in generative AI aspect into it. So we are offering Atlas Vector Search as part of our MongoDB offering. You can set it up inside MongoDB Atlas UI once you set up on AWS Cloud. And then what this offers is actually a semantic search experience. So as I mentioned before, MongoDB is a very, very flexible document database. You can store your vector embeddings that are required to power generative AI applications right next to your data in the database. And then once you have your data, you can actually query the database, run semantic search queries on top of it. So that will remove that operational heavy lifting. You don't have to set up multiple vector databases and your operational databases. You do everything in one database. How does it relate to AWS SageMaker Jumpstart, for example? There are four components always needed to build any Gen AI application. You need to have an embedding model. So if you have images, if you have technical manuals, let's say to fix a car, you need to go through a PDF file for technical manual. You have those things, you have to embed them. You have to create vector embeddings out of them. You can use SageMaker endpoint embedding models. It gives you all the access to all the different models. You can use one of those to embed, create vector embeddings, store those vector embeddings inside MongoDB Atlas, and then you can set up a SageMaker endpoint for a LLM to ask questions or ask queries through something like Amazon Lex. What MongoDB is providing here is the vector search capability. It will create that additional context that is required for your LLM model to generate an output that is not hallucination. You need to train your LLM model on real data. You don't want it to hallucinate and give you something wrong so that it results in a very bad customer experience. So that additional context with semantic search is provided by MongoDB Atlas, and then all the embedding models can be enabled via something like Amazon SageMaker Jumpstart. So that's how we work together. We published a blog post on it. It gives you step-by-step instructions on how to set this up. So take a moment to scan this QR code, and then I will show you how to put this into action for a connected vehicle use case. Pretty interesting, isn't it? So let's go back to our original diagram again. We have the vehicle. Again, we have Atlas Device SDK, which is a little database that runs inside the car. it's going to transmit the telemetry data automatically to MongoDB sitting on AWS cloud. And then we are also connected via the same link to a mobile application. Now we can run telemetry-based diagnostics easily. I showed you this before. But now let's put in the vector search and generative AI capability into it. So now what you can do is you can have audio files generated from the car. You can actually record the sound that your car is making, your car engine is making for ICE cars, and then create vector embeddings on it using Sage models catered for you through SageMaker, and push those vector embeddings in the same database, which is MongoDB. After that, you can set up your LLM model using SageMaker and connect that with MongoDB Vector Search. So using MongoDB Vector Search, it will give the additional context to the LLM model so that it can generate the right response to your query. In the same database, you have the telemetry data, you have the audio files vector embeddings, you have the technical manual embeddings inside, and then you have a predictive maintenance model running in SageMaker Studio. So we're running all sorts of analysis here. Now, when you take your car to a technician for after-sales support, they can use something like Amazon Lex and do this audio-based diagnostics. They can ask a question that this car is generating this kind of knocking sound and tell me exactly what I need to do to fix it. And what Vector Search will do is it will perform a semantic search on those audio embeddings, and it will perform a semantic search on the technical manual embeddings, and it will give the right context to the LLM model so that it can generate the right response, a very concise response, a non-hallucination response back to the technician so that they can easily go about their work and fix the car. And that will result in a very delightful customer experience, in my opinion. So that's how we work together. That's how you can set up, you can leverage Atlas Vector Search. You can leverage AWS for root cause diagnostics for a connected vehicle. And you can all set it up for free. You can, at least on the MongoDB side, we provide a free forever cluster. And then you can set up AWS services as well and get going.